You're watching Channel 4 with The Big Breakfast.
Some more money!
Yeah!
Hooray! It's 7 o'clock, it's the 25th of August 1994, and it's a Thursday.
Yes, I like Thursdays.
Roslin's looking gorgeous!
Thank you, and so are you,
thank
Christopher.
You, dear.
Shall I say what's coming on the show?
Yes, please.
Okay, Kevin Costner, 4. Keanu Reeves, 4. Alec Baldwin, 4. Nicolas Cage, 4. Chat about their brand new blockbuster in Snapchat and Pop Plus, Bill Roach. Coronation Street's Ken Barlow positively fascinates
now
us.
Now you do a call for Bill Roach right now.
Libel. Yes, when the stars talk, they talk to the Big Breakfast.
Hey!
Cool.
Okay, carry on with the show. Yes, also, we reveal why this man is stark naked. And he is stark naked. Toby Tompkins Love Bucket has the clues in this week's Who's Shoes?
Who's Shoes? Who's Shoes? Wait for the clues and guess Who's Shoes?
And discover why German men have invented their very own toilet paper that is exclusive to the male body.
Oh.
Yeah, women can't use it.
Oh, all right.
Toilet paper only for men on this morning
be
show.
Be selfish.
Now, I've got to tell you something. Today's a very special day because 600,000 students opened their GCSE results today, and apparently grades are exceptionally good, supposedly because the tests have been very easy this year. Now, we've got this year's English language exam paper here with us right now. Look at that, you see? That's what a lot of people sat this year.
Ooh,
and we also have Ardu Vakil from Pimlico School. Hello, Ardu.
Hello.
How are you?
Welcome.
Hi. Welcome to the show. Now, you're an examiner, aren't you?
That's right.
Okay, and you could mark this paper for us.
Yes.
If somebody did it.
Yeah.
And what the crew don't know is that we're going to make one of them sit the English language exam today during the show. And as they answer each question, you'll take the paper off them and mark it.
That's right.
And at the end of the show, we should see if one of our crew, who have obviously sat these tests before, will pass. But who's it going to be? Will it be Zandra's? Zandra, did they have GCSEs in Ireland?
Oh, no.
No, but it was a long time ago. No, it was a long time ago. It's a genuine question. So, well, it's not fair on you. Pete, you'd fly with pass with flying colours. There's no point in that. So, in fact, it's going to be, and it always was, Danny Steghorn.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Danny, what you don't know is that we've actually hired another camera assistant for this morning's show.
Yeah. Okay.
So you've got 2 hours, mate. You go in there. Come in.
This
meet
is
Ardu.
For real, Danny. Ardu
Vakil. Okay. And if you just go through here,
so
Dan.
Worried. Good luck.
I
just
am
go through
worried.
There, John.
I am worried.
Just check
I'm
it out. Check the examination desk
shaking.
Out. And there you go. So it's quiet from there. That is the examination hall. In fact, it's our hall, but it's the examination hall today. And Danny's got 2 hours to complete his English language exam. How did you do first time round, Dan?
I got spoken English, Chris.
Spoken English?
Yeah, but that's not going to be very good for
no,
me.
No,
now,
no, no. Okay, but you've got to start and start right now, okay? Ardu, you sit down, make sure he doesn't talk to anybody. Come on, quick. Turn your papers over now.
I'm looking.
It's 3 minutes past seven. He's got 2 hours, and here's the news.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Thursday, August the 25th. Helicopters and lifeboats in Channel Ferry rescue. Two England athletes leave the Commonwealth Games amid drug allegations. And pupils score best ever GCSE results. Lifeboats, helicopters and a tug are heading for a ferry after a fire broke out in its engine room. 121 people are aboard the Sally Star off the Kent coast. No one's been hurt, but it's drifting without engines near the Goodwin Sands. Paul Edwards and Diane Modal, the England athletes withdrawn from the Commonwealth Games under a cloud, have both left Canada. Shot putter Edwards has been linked with a positive drug test at the European Championships in Helsinki a fortnight ago. 800 metres runner Modal officially pulled out because of a family bereavement. Athletics officials will make a statement about drug allegations later today. More pupils than ever have passed their GCSEs this year and achieved top grades. For the seventh year running, results have improved. But leader of the National Union of Teachers, Doug McAvoy, denies that the exams are getting easier.
What these results show is we should disregard those who, because they have sour grapes, criticise the standard of achievement and praise those who have achieved.
A man today faces a murder charge after police found human remains in the garden of a house in Leicestershire. Police believe they found the body of Jean Crowe, who lived at the house in Colville until she vanished 16 years ago. A man will appear at the town's magistrates later today. A British computer engineer appears in court in Thailand today accused of heroin smuggling. Matthew Jones from London is expected to plead guilty to avoid the death penalty. He was caught with 1.8 kilograms of the drug at a Bangkok hotel. Letitia Dean is set to quit EastEnders after 10 years of the top-rated soap. The Queen Vic landlady will pull her last pint next year, but bosses say she could make a comeback. Take That have been banned from performing a daring stunt when they kick off their UK tour in Glasgow tonight. The band's been told that plans to suspend themselves from the ceiling above the audience are too dangerous. Mark Owen says they're disappointed, but are still looking forward to going on the road.
But you're immediately getting a reaction from the fans, and it's great for us. It keeps us on a buzz and puts us on a high.
Rangers' European Cup campaign ended last night at Ibrox as the Scottish champions crashed out 1-0 to AEK Athens. Savevski's goal inflicted another early knockout for Rangers as they went out 3-0 on aggregate. Newcastle shrugged off the absence of Peter Beardsley with a comfortable 4-0 victory over Coventry last night. Three goals up by half-time, Andy Cole joined in the act with his second goal of the season. Jurgen Klinsmann lived up to the hype in Spurs' 2-1 victory over Everton. The German striker scored twice in the first 36 minutes of his debut at White Hart Lane. Now let's look at the weather. Well, England and Wales will have sunny spells with a few showers. Scotland and Northern Ireland will have more frequent spells of rain. Temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. 6 minutes past seven is the time. We'll be back with more news at 20 past seven. Here's Chris and Gabby.
And we look forward to that, Angela, as we always do when you're doing the news. It is 6 minutes past seven, as she says. It's Thursday morning. It's the day before Friday, which is the day before the weekend.
Yes! And today's birthday. Happy birthday to Stephanie Glass from Sutton in Surrey. And that's with love from your Auntie Pam. Isn't she cute? Aww. Stephanie, 16 today, and Aunt Pam sent her this picture because she knows it'll make you cringe. Happy birthday, Steph.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, it's very sweet.
It's a cutie. Oh, is that a gingham shirt?
It is.
Lovely. Birthdays, celebrity birthdays today. Well, before we tell you who the celebrity birthdays are and how old they are, it's time to scare the children.
I saw.
Because we have a man here in his birthday suit. And every Thursday, with the birthdays, will be a man in his birthday suit. Absolutely starkers, completely. And birthdays today, Frederick Forsyth. Frederick Forsyth there. He's 56 years old. Are you following this? Have you got what's going to happen soon? Elvis Costello's got a birthday, as you can see. 40 years old today. Happy birthday, Elvis. Joanne Wally Kilmer is 33 today. Happy birthday, Joanne. And Claudia Schiffer is only 24. 24 years old today. Happy birthday. Yeah. You're an expert, are you? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Right.
You're going to leave now? Go on, then. We didn't rehearse his exit. I said this needed rehearsal. He's got to go sometime. He can't hang around there forever. Can't keep a man like that hanging around.
Oh, no!
Now, today's question of the day. Because we've just had a naked man on the show, and we want to know, have you ever been caught with your kit off, or have you ever caught anyone else with their kit off?
Oh, wait, 1-985-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-
to think these things through. When that you've got a naked scary man on the show, you've got to think these things through.
Absolutely. But he got out of there.
Yeah. He's still to come on the show. He's more fun than Tom and Jerry, Yogi Bear, the Flintstones too. We're talking about the Rinky Dinky Pinky Panther. Plus, Zig and Zag and Ben the Boffin reveal how you can win a visit from Ben and the Challenger rig to your very own little school.
But it's now 8 minutes past seven. Yeah. Now, 8 minutes past seven. Yeah. Time to meet the family.
Hi, there. We're the Foster family from Barnes in Sunderland.
Hi, my name's Vicky, and I want to tell you about the rest of my family. First, there's my mum, Olwyn. My dad's called Bobby. My older sister's called Katie. She's been going out with Keith for 2 years, and they got engaged last Christmas. Then there's my best friend, Julie. We treat her like one of the family.
OK, now I'm here with Bobby, the dad of the week. He's a bit of a tipster. He loves horse racing. How long have you been best friends?
Since we were about six.
Hot tip today is Pierre Bosco.
Pierre Bosco? Did you become best friends straight away?
No, Vicky ran away from me. First day we met.
Where did it come in the race?
Second. Beaten in a photo finish, though. Very, very close.
When did you actually become best friends after that?
About first year seniors, about 6-7 years ago.
What's your tip for today, then?
Well, today we're going for a winner, and it's Exhibit A.
How
often are you with the family?
I'm with them virtually every weekend during school time.
4 o'clock at Brighton.
And what are the odds on that at the moment?
2.5 to 1. 5 to 2.
So, OK, yesterday's horse was Exhibit Air. Tell us.
13-8 winner.
Win! He had a win yesterday. Fantastic. OK, and the horse today?
The horse today is Crystal Magic and the 4 o'clock at Lingfield Park.
OK, 4 o'clock at Lingfield Park. Crystal Magic. Yeah. I hope this one wins as well. That would be a great way to end the week. Thank you very much. OK, now, you asked me yesterday if you could do something very special today. Now, is this true that every month last year, for your anniversary, you gave your beautiful fiancé a rose?
Yeah.
And every and month this year, what have you done?
It's been a cuddly tie every month.
On the anniversary?
Yeah, every month.
And apparently yesterday was the anniversary, so you rushed out and you bought her something and you want to present it to her on the show. Oh. He's so sweet. Come on, open it, let's have a look.
Oh,
oh, isn't he a lovely fiancé to have?
Is he a little happy?
Yeah. Oh, just a romantic moment then again from the fiancés of the week. Okay, now you two. You go a bit soppy, because that was really quite soppy, but you go a bit soppy over the Beatles, don't you?
Yeah.
How long have you liked them for?
4 years now.
Why do you like the Beatles so much?
Because we like their personalities and their music, and there seems to be like a song to suit every mood like that you're in. So you...
That's actually a jolly good reason to like them, I suppose. Now, apparently you once went on to Abbey Road and had your photo taken on the zebra crossing.
Yeah, yes. But we took their pictures with my camera
and
it broke.
Oh, no, so you didn't get the pictures?
No.
Well, guess what? We're going to give you a ticket to ride. Oh, yes, we're going to help you. It hasn't been a hard day's night. Oh, no. This, the Abbey Roads. There we are. There's their picture. Here's the camera. And guess where you're going today? You are going to be recreating that with the family. You're going to be recreating the Abbey Road cover, all right? And also, you're going to go into the studios and there's people performing and you're going to see records being made and everything. All right? So there we go.
Thank
you. Have a good day. Tell us all about it and show us the pictures tomorrow, all right? It's now 11 minutes past 7. Here's the Pink Panther.
Think pink.
So, you wanna be Minuteman, huh?
Yes, sir! Sergeant Yorkshire, sir!
Then follow the example of our finest Minuteman, Mr. Paul Revere.
Quit dreaming, lackey.
Minuteman Revere will demonstrate Minuteman marksmanship. Now, you!
Lucky shot, lackey.
Our volunteers must fend off the enemy in a minute's notice.
Hence the name Minute Men, lackey.
You have 60 seconds.
Now, whatever did I do with that watch? I had it just a minute ago. Ah, silly me. Here it is. And go!
Whoa!
Tick, tick, tick.
Time?
Exactly 1 minute! And 5 seconds. Oh, don't worry. We've still got a nice, stable position for you. So clean out those stalls, laggy.
All right, do you go for designer colors?
I really must be tidy, you know, because when they light the signal, I'll ride and warn the villagers. Oh, the glory! The townsmen will sing songs about me. The townswomen will make me pies. Why, I'll be revered!
the British are expected. No, the British are arriving unannounced. No, that's not it either.
Well, how about the British are coming?
How lame. The British are crashing the party. No.
Men, our most important advantage is the element of surprise.
Then why do we wear bright red and march to a loud drum beat in a perfectly straight line?
Neatness always counts.
The British don't have their passports. That's a good one. The British are the skittish are bumming. I mean, the Yiddish are humming. I mean, the British are there.
Paul, no time to nap on the job. This is it. Get up, get up. The British are coming. Someone must warn the citizenry. Is this gonna be cool or what? Horse in the colonies without anti-lock brakes.
Well, be waving, but yet another controversial installment of the Pink Panther, the Rinky Dink Man, and it's actually caused another need for a public announcement. So let's go over once again to our public announcement facility.
Although you saw the Pink Panther skiing down the steps with floorboards nailed to his feet, we do not recommend you do this. Unless you're an Olympic gold medal skier or a successful cartoon character.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I hope we don't have any more controversial installments of that.
Controversial.
Controversial.
No, we don't want any more controversial installments.
I've got two things to tell you today.
Have you?
Yeah.
You're going to save them?
Two jokes.
Yeah.
That's all.
You're going to save
them? I'm leaving it
all
there.
Right. Okay.
Two jokes.
I can't wait.
On the way.
Okay. I'll wait.
Today's question of the day. Because earlier on we had a naked man on the show, and there he is. We want to know, have you ever been caught with your kit off? Or have you ever caught anybody else with their kit off?
John Curtis, this is the only time I'm going to read one like this out because we've all heard this before. Nottingham. I was on holiday in Greece when the fire alarm went off. I ran outside, the door slammed behind me and it was a false alarm and I had to go down to reception to get a spare key in my birthday suit.
No way!
Well, that's what he says, but you've heard that before. I want sort of... bit sort of, you know, risque stories,
you're
please.
Grimy one,
0801 9852 222. Stories, please.
Now, just do that again. Hold that up there again, like you did then, please, Gaby. John, what am I supposed to do? Exactly. What am I supposed to do?
Oh, you half in again?
Oh, no, I was all in, but with nothing to do. Go on. Just give it the phone number.
Oh, 0801 9852 222.
Time for a bit of respite. It's 7:18. Coming up in 15 minutes, Zig Zag and Ben the Boffin reveal how to win the Challenger Games rig at your very own school. And also later on, we meet Ben the Boffin's celebrity goldfish.
I'm looking forward to that.
Which is highly exciting. And in just 6 minutes, Katie from the Family of the Week reveals what she gets up to in bed. Also, we're going to join Amanda, who is from Byker Grove, as she receives her GCSE results. So she opens them up. She's going to be on the phone, and she's going to open it up for us and tell us exactly what she's got this morning.
Very exciting. But it's now 19 minutes past seven. Two jokes?
Two jokes
right,
on the way.
19 minutes past seven. The question is, where is Shara Nelson going? Remember, don't phone. It's just for fun.
3. Masses of the best dance hits with The Prodigy, Max, Eternal and Capella. Massive hits from D-Ream, The Grid, Snap and Two Cowboys. The original smash from Dawn Penn. Two Unlimited, Culture Beat, Aswa, M-People, Reel to Reel and much more. 20 maximum dance hits. Dance to the Max 3.
Do you love anyone enough to give them your last roller? Soft golden toffee in a milk chocolate cup.
Welcome back to the Big Breakfast. The question was, where was Sharon Nelson going? Down that road. And that was exclusive clip from Sharon Nelson's new single, Down That Road, out next week, and she's here with Zig Zag next Wednesday.
Kids play that game all the time. I hate it, don't you? Is anybody here today? Is it just me? Just me and you and Gab. Gab's here as well.
I'm
and Angela's here. John's here because he's holding the camera, but really there's nobody else here. These are all like waxworks here because the crew are so famous. They've all got waxworks and they sent all the waxworks in today and they've all got a sneaky day off. And they're all having fantastic times elsewhere, in bed probably, with each other. And now, oh, Forrest Gump. Now it's 7:21, still to come on the show, Ben the Boffin celebrity pet, and also we have the toilet paper that's only for men only.
Oh, that's quite silly.
And on the day that 600,000 people receive their GCSE results, we have set one of our crew here the English language paper. And there is Danny now, Danny Stegall. He's a camera assistant. Now, he's been doing it 22 minutes now, and the reason he's only written two lines is because he's actually read through all the paper
yeah,
first,
did,
like a proper student.
Ooh. And I went to him and I said, how are you feeling? He said, really spooky.
He's doing the actual English language paper that was set this year.
But you've all done.
Yes.
So you know exactly what he's writing there. But it's now 7:22. Here's Angela with the news.
And the top stories this morning. A major rescue is underway for a Channel ferry after a fire knocked out its engines. The Sally Star, carrying 121 people, is drifting helplessly close to the treacherous Goodwin Sands off Kent. The British Athletics Federation will today make a statement on the growing controversy of drugs in the sport. It coincides with reports that two English athletes, Diane Modell and Paul Edwards, have tested positive for banned substances. Surviving members of Nirvana are releasing a double album of the band's live recordings in tribute to Kurt Cobain. Verse, chorus, verse features previously unreleased performances of the singer, who killed himself 4 months ago. England's cricket selectors announced today who'll lead the winter tour to Australia. But despite a summer of controversy, Mike Atherton is expected to retain his job. Now let's look at the weather. Sunny spells and showers across the country. Temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. 23 minutes past seven. We'll be back at 20:08 with more news. Here's Gabby.
Thank you very much, Angela. I was just having a sneaky look at Danny in there. He's taking his exams in there. And I just asked Katie, the eldest daughter of the family of the week, and I'm in shock because I didn't know this. Did you take your GCSE English?
Yes.
What result did you get?
An A.
How many A's did you get in your GCSEs?
10.
Ooh. This girl got 10 A's! You're part of the 3% in this country then. This is even more fascinating because, you know, I was going to say to you, why don't you read grown-up books like Jilly Cooper and Jackie Collins and watch films like Fatal Attraction and Basic Instinct, because apparently you just read all the kids' books.
Yeah.
But now I'm absolutely fascinated by this because you apparently just read The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe and Enid Blyton and all these mm-hmm. things. Yeah. This girl who has 10 O-levels, all grade A. Why all the Enid Blyton and things like that?
Because it's a lot easier to wind down with them and read them from start to finish, you know, in an hour and a half. And they're so funny. And they're just hilarious. I don't know, there's nothing serious about it. The dogs can do wonderful things, the children do wonderful things, you know, that you could never do yourself.
Did you read them when you were a child?
Oh, I have, but I appreciate them a lot more now. I appreciate the humour now. When I was little, I loved the stories. But now I appreciate, like, the sarcasm and the real humour. They were written by adults, so obviously an adult's going to appreciate the real humour behind it.
Well, this is fascinating.
I think it's fantastic.
What's your favourite one?
I like all the Lion Witch in the Wardrobe series, the C.S. Lewis.
Yes,
I love
wonderful.
Them. And they're quite adult anyway, they're for older children. But if I'm just wanting a quick book to read, I read Enid Blyton.
Really?
The Famous Five. But I haven't read them for a while. The Mallory Towers, I think, they're great.
Really, the Mallory Towers? And who would be your favourite character?
Out of all the Enid Blyton?
Yeah.
George, it's the girl out of the Famous Five,
yeah.
Yeah,
why do you like her?
She's the daring one. She hides from the smugglers and crouches in the little caves.
Did you ever sort of imagine yourself as a bit of a George?
All the time.
That's what it was. Yeah. Well, I was supposed to hand you over all these Jilly Cooper and the rivals and all of that, but I think I have to agree with you, so you don't mind if I borrow your Enid Blyton, do you? Thank you very much. Time to go inside and upstairs for the crunch.
It's a very special day for the people
yes,
in French France.
Yes,
today is their 50th anniversary of Paris being independentized.
Wow!
They had independentized
liberation
about
of Paris.
50 years ago, and it's been all right now. 50 years, they've been free.
Yeah!
It's been a lovely thing.
Lovely and beautiful.
Actually, we're expecting a phone call from France any moment.
Any moment now.
Oh, that could be.
That's
it.
Probably it.
You didn't even look, did you?
No,
intuition. Amazing. Intuition between me and Toby Tumpkin Love Bucket over
Toby
there.
Toby Tumpkin Love Bucket!
There you are.
Hi, Toby!
Hi! Would you like to see it again?
What? The throw?
The throw of the catch, the head?
No,
I'd love
not
to.
Really.
You wouldn't?
No.
Okay.
Okay, go on then. Let's
go on!
Well, we'd never do it again.
Can we do it in slow motion?
Let's see it in slow motion. Let's see how good it really was.
All right.
Whoa!
That
was some cat. Oh, hello?
Oh, there's someone on
yes?
The line. I almost forgot. Yes?
Who?
Yes?
Who is it?
Who is it?
Well, it's a French lady, but she keeps repeating herself.
Oh, that must be Vanessa Parakeet.
No, it's only for you anyway.
Is it
anyway.
Vanessa? Yeah.
She may be the one yeah. I love
enough. Yeah, well, Big Me's up in Paris tonight.
What?
Yeah, the
anniversary.
No, Vanessa, sorry, love.
Before.
I won't be able to make it. No,
oh,
I have
yes,
to, I have to feed the neighbour's cat. Sorry.
No, you don't. If you've got a chance to go to Paris to a big party with Vanessa Parakeet, we'll feed the cat, won't we, Zig?
No, Chris, I have to pick up my dry cleaning.
We'll do that.
No, I'll
tell you, he can go.
Ah, I'm sorry, love, I can't go. I have to watch the bill. Thanks, bye.
She's gone.
That was good, wasn't
it? That was blooming good, all right? That was excellent. Chris!
What?
Chris, I just don't really want to go.
I just
got to
talk about the phone call for a second.
Oh, okay.
As funny as that was.
Charles!
And my word, that was funny.
Paris is not my kind of place.
But
Chris,
you just got the
like
chance to go to a party to Paris.
Chris, I've been banned from France.
What?
Totally and utterly banned.
Why?
They've put a ban on my visa.
Why?
Well, just a little run-in I had with the president.
Well, last time you were there. Oh, no!
Yeah, you know the way I had that big dinner party?
Well, I heard you were going to see him, yeah.
Well, I only know one French phrase, right?
Right.
I kind of happened to say it to him.
What, to the president?
Yeah. It was Je vous en prie en sortir vous en nos cités across the Atlantic.
You said that to the French president?
Yes.
And what does it mean?
Get your knobbly nuts out.
Oh, no!
I'm sorry, but that's what happens at this big occasion.
Just get your knobbly nuts out to President Mrs. Meathron.
Yes!
Unbelievable.
Yeah,
the king of France.
King, president.
Question about the clip.
Well, the question about the clip is, Julien Mossoge, oh, sorry, just a bit of French. And name this famous basketball player, but remember, don't phone, it's just for fun.
Urban drives there. Ho, ho!
And I hope they don't put none of them little boy pictures up in there. No teeth. You're going to get to see me when nobody else has seen me the way I look.
Is there any questions before I get started?
HMV presents the brand new Heavies. With the hits Dream On Dreamer, Back to Love, and their stunning new smash, Midnight at the Oasis. All featured on the brilliant new album, Brother Sister. The brand new Heavies at HMV. No HMV, no music.
The bright sunshine of a Saturday.
You're reading a book.
It's a talking book, actually.
A talking book.
One for all
for one.
Hey, what's going on?
We're reading.
They're reading.
Come to life talking books. Trust Tomy to make reading fun.
For cuts and grazes this summer, apply some Savvy. Apply some Savlon.
It's magic time.
Oh! Oh! Where did that come from?
7:31, the question about the Clippers.
Why not?
Name that. It's no time.
Okay.
It's no time. Name that news. Famous basketball player, Magic Johnson. And that was from Magic Johnson, the greatest basketball player of all time. And there's more of him in Snap Exclusive tomorrow.
And you Magic can actually Johnson. Play basketball with Magic Johnson.
Yes, you
if
can.
You enter our Who's Washing Line Is It Anyway competition, which is normally at this time, but of course for this week only, because big prizes at stake. We're doing it about 10 to 8. In fact, about 16 minutes to 8 this morning,
yeah.
I think. And you could win a Club Pepsi Max holiday in Ibiza. You've got to be between 18 and 30 to go. So if you're not between 18 and 30 and you win it, you've got to give it to somebody that's between 18 and 30. And as well as being able to play basketball with Magic Johnson, you may be able to hit tennis balls with Pat Cash because they've flown him out there too.
Wow.
And better than that, you can dribble with George Best because they've flown him out there too. And you can see Sybil in concert because they've flown her out there too.
And the number for you to call if you want to go, 0899-133-3111. Of course, you cost no more than 25 pence. If you want to go, you have to play Who's Washing Line?
Forrest Gump! You've seen Forrest Gump.
It's fantastic.
Forrest Gump!
It's fantastic.
It's 7:32. Ben the Boffin with his new partners.
You don't have to go upstairs.
New partners.
Ben's up there.
Not as good as it was, but never mind. Here's Ben the Boffin with Master Blaster.
Get lost! Get lost, Zig! You're not coming in!
Let me in!
No!
Go away!
Go away, it's me and Ben! Hi, Ben, the old mate.
Funny that, because the door was kind of jammed shut and I couldn't get in.
Really, Zig?
Really?
Oh, dear,
yeah,
that's terrible,
Zig. Yeah, kind of stuck with a load of books and things.
Anyway, Ben, the old mate, Master Blaster time again!
Yeah.
We're just sneaking into your bedroom once more.
All right.
To have a little chit-chat.
Yeah.
Ben, how are you, my old mate?
Not bad. Got any sweets?
You back to school soon?
Reasonably soon, yeah. Got any cake?
We don't go
to
school.
Got any pop?
Yeah,
nothing
Ben.
For you.
Ben, what games are we going to be looking at today?
The first game we're looking at is Super Battle Tanks 2 on the Super Nintendo.
Cool, because you know stuff about Super Nintendo, don't you? You know stuff about games, every game.
You can be our brother, Ben!
Yeah, Ben, you can be our brother.
Yeah!
I'll just have a rest while you have a chit-chat about the game.
Well, this is a battle... Well, this is, as stated by the...
Oh, that looks good.
As stated by the name, this is a battle tank simulator.
Blimey.
And it is very good fun. There's
you're inside the tank,
yeah,
that view!
You are actually, like, inside the tank, driving the tank.
That's quite unusual, isn't it?
Guns. There's lots of different scenarios to play in, and we're playing in a sort of nighttime scenario here.
Desert storm type vibe.
Yeah, and you can use all sorts of different weapons in the game.
And you can come outside, you can have a view from the outside
as
well.
Yes, yeah, this is...
That is
brilliant!
What are the graphics? What would you rate the graphics on that like?
The graphics on this are brilliant.
They are pretty
graphics
good, aren't
on
they?
This are very spectacular. It's an excellent game.
And how much is that?
I like the way it kind
this
of looks
is
like
is
$49.99.
You're paying for that level of graphics, though, aren't you, Ben?
If you like simulators, then this is definitely one to go for.
Cool. So it's recommended. What about what's the next one we're looking at?
Next one we're looking at is Stunt Race FX.
Stunt Race FX. That sounds good. What's that? What system's that on?
This is on the Super Nintendo as well.
Cool.
This, oh. Well, this game utilises the SFX chip, which was...
Oh, yeah, about in, the, yeah, yeah.
The SFX chip, which was in use for the...
What's
was,
that about, Zag? The SFX chip?
It's one that uses FSX, yeah.
Huh?
It was the same chip that was in use for Starwing. And that's why it's got the same sort of polygon graphics. This game is quite good fun.
How come the wheels aren't joined properly to the car?
I think that's something to do with the polygon graphics, but it's fun anyway.
What's the boredom factor of that?
Boredom factor, a two.
Two?
Two boredom, so you actually think it's quite good?
Yes.
And how much is that one?
That one is $49.99 as well.
Blimey. Mm. And tell us,
and this, no, before, you see, but you know the game before that? What was the boredom factor in that, the chopper game?
The game before that?
Yeah.
You mean the tank game, Zig?
The same thing, right?
You weren't even watching
Get lost!
It.
What was the boredom factor, Ben?
Three.
So it wasn't very good. Ben, tell us about the juggernaut that's going around the country. It's been a huge success.
The Challenger, yeah.
The Challenger, and it's got games in. For up to 50 people can play.
Got any cake?
Do you have to share
got any pop?
Tell us a bit about it, because apparently there's a competition we're going to run this morning.
Well,
where if you design a game, isn't it, you can have the juggernaut called the Challenger arrive at your school for a day.
Wow.
Yes.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah. How can you see with your hat down over your eyes like that?
I can't, I'm just memorising it.
Oh, right.
Anyway, Ben, tell us a little bit about this, because we've got VT to show with it.
Yeah,
of the
let's have a little look at the VT, actually.
Okay, cool. Cool! So that can arrive at your school for a full day.
Yeah.
What do you have to do again?
Well, what you have to do is you have to design a big breakfast computer game on paper, and you have to send in your ideas and your sketches.
Cool.
And the best idea, we think, will win the Challenger for
the
a
challenger
day.
The Challenger for a day? That's 50 people can play. All of cool. Okay, what kind of games are in it?
You have to put your own petrol in, or does it come with petrol?
What kind of games are in it? In the
Street Fighter 2, Super Metroid, FIFA International Soccer.
Cool. That'd be excellent having all your schoolmates playing in that, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. It'd be
great. So we'll send it to the usual address, Master Blaster, two Lockkeepers Cottages, all for London
E3 2AM.
I wish you wouldn't do that, put it over my face.
Well, it just... I think it's got a nice little effect to it.
Yeah, this is Channel 4, you're watching The Big Breakfast.
Ben, where are you going this weekend?
Oh, Ben, the weekend!
Ben, where are you going this weekend?
Toby! Do you have to shout that every time? Do you? Where are you going, Ben?
I am going to... hold on. I'm just going
to... You can pull it out, Ben, we have got all day. Toby, don't you dare shout over me, Ben.
I am going to the Town and Country Festival in Stoneleigh Park, Warwickshire.
Well, there's the plug. That's where the challenger will be, with Ben the Boffin live in the flesh. This is Channel 4, you're watching The Big Breakfast. Toby, I want a word with you.
Hit it.
The Big Breakfast.
You don't have to be big to have a big breakfast. In fact, I have a tiny breakfast, but I always watch The Big Breakfast show.
So that's how you can win a visit from Ben and the Challenger to your school, you just found out. But now it's time to pull the winner of last week's prize, which was this. Yes, this lovely, lovely kite that...
Oh, that's good. That may not look much, because frankly, it is only a kite, and you can get kites for £1.25.
Yeah.
Because I did a couple of weeks ago. But that's worth £100, that kite.
£100.
And it's a top-notch kite thing.
Okay, now, we asked you, in which movie did Dick Van Dyke...
Loads of entries, look in there!
Yeah, it's full! It is completely full!
Absolutely full!
The answer, Mary Poppins.
So many entries!
Oh. And the winner is William Sanker from Darcy Lever in Bolton. William, you've got a kite to fly.
Today's question of the day. Well done, Ted. Have you ever been caught with your kit off? Because earlier on the show, we had a naked man on. And, there he is.
Yes.
Look at the expression on my face. I'm rather too pleased to see him naked there. I was like, oh. Look at the expression on your face, Roslin. Let's do it again. That's fantastic. Okay, so have you ever seen anybody naked or you've been naked? Paul Underwood from Eastbourne. I'm a lifeguard at a sports centre, that's no excuse, and one day a woman walked onto the poolside completely stark us. As everyone started to stare at her, I walked towards her to remind her of the club rules, and she screamed and ran away saying that she'd forgotten to put her costume on.
0198511 or
0868 1852222. When I used to have a motorbike, I went to work all the way to work one morning without my helmet on. And I only when I got to work and I got 3 miles without my helmet on. True, honest Joe. Yeah, you can't make things like that up. That was dull, wasn't it?
Yes, thanks for
sharing that with us.
The question about the clip is, who's the man in the flat cap in the bin?
But don't phone.
It's just for fun.
We can help you run your day-to-day finances smoothly and efficiently with credit cards, cash dispensers, convenient switch payments, and Maxim, a check account that can pay you regular interest. Why would you want to be with anyone else? Get a little extra help from the Halifax.
Today, we're going to show you how to make a tasty saving. Just cut one token from each of these 6 McVitie's packs. Here's some we bought earlier. Pop them in the post, and a little later, you'll get all your money back.
McVitie's. You have to go a long, long way to find a better biscuit.
A reason.
The taste of paradise.
Welcome back. The question was, who was the man in the flat cap?
Who was it, Gab?
Danger Man Patrick McGoon.
Was it really?
Yes. Was from Danger Man, last seen TV in the mid-80s, originally shown in black and white, and is considered by some a classic of the espionage genre. It's out to buy now, $10.99.
Unbelievable, Gabby Roslin. And isn't it true, Joe? Isn't it true, Joe?
Yeah.
That one of the channels is going to put a load of 60s things on.
Yes. Who
is it, Channel 4 or BBC 2?
BBC 2, ATV.
ATV,
this weekend.
All the ATV things.
It's going to be fantastic on Saturday
Well,
night.
I won't be there because, of course, I'll be at Reading, at the Reading Festival.
Oh, yes, of course you will.
I thought it was the Reading Festival.
Bring your book.
I'm sorry. It's 7:43, still to come. We meet Ben the Boffin's celebrity pet. It's a goldfish. And also, we show you the toilet paper that's only for men.
Silly.
Not for girls. And it's not silly.
Well, I haven't seen it yet.
You have, you're live, we rehearsed it just.
7:43, here's the news.
And the top stories this morning. A fire has left a Channel ferry drifting without engines off the Kent coast. Helicopters and ships are now racing towards the Sally Star to evacuate over 100 passengers. England's Commonwealth Games team has suffered yet another setback with the withdrawal of 800 metres champion Diane Modell. A team spokesman says her decision followed a family bereavement. Some reports have linked her to drug allegations. Teachers are dismissing critics who say today's record results in the GCSE show that the exams are too easy. More pupils than ever have passed and achieved top grades. England's John Regis shrugged off an Achilles injury for a place in the 200-metre semi-finals at the Commonwealth Games. Regis cruised through his heat, smashing the Games record with a time of 20.36 seconds. Other weather, sunny spells and showers across the country. Temperatures are around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. It's 7:44. We'll be back at 8 with the main news. Here's Gammy.
Thank you very much, Angela. OK, now, we're standing outside in the rain, but don't feel sorry for us. Oh, no, feel very sorry for Danny Stegall, our lovely camera assistant, who is resitting his GCSE English exam. We actually did this... put a surprise on him 7 o'clock this morning, and he really has got to sit his exam for the next 2 hours, and he's a little bit worried about it, but we're all edging him on. He'll be fine. Now I'm outside to do Whose Washing Line Is It Anyway with the family of the week and a very special Keith Cam. Look, we've got Keith Cam out here. It's just sort of you. We can actually see all of you, but it looks like it's just Keith Cam. If you give us a wave, go on. Oh, no, yes, with that hand. Yes, don't give away the clues. There we are. Now this is to take the close-ups of the sudden things that just might happen on Whose Washing Line Is It Anyway. And you can win that fantastic trip to that club with all those stars in Ibiza. Who's on line one?
Nick from Leeds.
Who are you from Leeds?
Dominic.
Dominic, hiya, how old are you?
24.
You're 24, you could go if you win that trip. Okay, would you like clue number 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5? And do it quickly, because it's pouring with rain, Dominic.
3.
Number 3, from Vicky.
It's a wolf mask.
A wolf mask. Who do you think it could be?
Jack Nicholson.
Dominic! You're going to Ibiza and I can go inside and get dry. Thank you very much. Have a fantastic time. And as I said all week, will you please send me a postcard?
Yeah.
All right, then. Now, I'm going to show you what else we had as well, just for the hell of it. Then we've got a red herring, we've got Michelle Pfeiffer, got a carjack, and we've got Joker, because he was Joker in the Batman films. Thank you very much. OK, now, family, I'd like you to do the honours for me. It's 7:45. Could you please shout?
Where are you, Keith?
Thank you.
Gosh, a noise down here. Very, very good morning to you. Yeah, we go to all the top festivals. We've been to Phoenix. And today is no excuse. We're at one of the top festivals in Britain. We're at Reading Festival. We got Down Your Doorstep special this morning because we've got a letter from Janet Cole up in Newcastle, who tells us about her husband, Brian Cole. Now, his job is to come to every festival. He's been to loads up and down the country, and his job is to clean up after the rock stars. Well, we've got some rock stars at the moment. They're doing a bit of a sound check. It's Chuck, who's got a brand new single out called Jump. But what they don't know is we're going to reverse roles this morning. We're going to get the rock stars cleaning up after the cleaners. He's right on the other side of Reading Festival in a porter cabin. Fingers crossed he's still asleep. We're going to clean up their porter cabin. We might even try and get them a Winnebago this morning. But the rock stars don't know. We've got an ironing board, we've got irons, we've got hoovers, feather dusters and more to clean up after our cleaners. And right now, here's a group of people who need no cleaning up. Yeah, because they're the smartest people around. Time to meet the family.
Hi there. We're the Foster family from Barnes in Sunderland.
There must be some bad points.
Junie drives us up the wall.
Vicky goes on about things. Well, not goes on about them, but if you tell her not to do something, she'll do it 10 times worse.
Because she's just so tidy all the time. She's just, and like, and I'm dead messy, and I don't care if there's like dirty underwear and things lying about in my bedroom.
And here they are around the table, because we rushed in from the outside, because it is time for Vicky to dish the dirt. Now, this is the most bizarre time this has ever happened, because usually the family will say, oh, we're not looking forward to this, but Vicky is worried about this. Why are you worried? What they might do to you afterwards?
No.
Don't be worried, Vicky. I'm here with you all the way. OK, Vicky, go first with your mum.
Right, she was going for our first interview to be a teacher, and they didn't have much money because they just got married, so she hand-washed her bra and tights.
Yeah.
And she didn't, and like, when she got up the next morning, they weren't dry, so she put them on the fire, and she went through to grab a bit of breakfast, and when she came back, the cup of the bra had burned out, and so had the tights, the foot of her tight had, like, burnt off as well. So she had to go into the interview, and she was a bit lopsided, really, because one...
Everything was sort of falling out of one of the sides.
More,
oh, dear. No, you can't know more about that one. OK, thank you very much. All the way in. Oh, how embarrassing. Bobby, go on. Dish it out your dad.
Well, he really prides himself on his DIY, and he thinks he's great. And he made this ornamental, like, wheelbarrow, and loads of paint, and it was really heavy because it was full of mud, and it had, like, loads of soil, and it had flowers in. And my dad was, loads of people had came round, and he was saying, oh, look at me lovely wheelbarrow, because he likes to show off. And he picked it up, and when he picked it up to demonstrate how it worked, it all fell to bits, and there was mud and flowers everywhere.
Oh, no, did that happen? Embarrassing moments that you don't want to be in mind of. Yes, he's blushing a bit. OK, Katie, your sister.
Oh, Katie, well, she's a dizzy blonde. It just really seemed that she is.
Nothing wrong with being blonde, Katie.
But she is, when she's hopeless with her car. because we've both got, just got two minis, and she used to have a Renault 5, which was a, it was petrol, no, it was unleaded petrol, and she put petrol, no, unleaded petrol in the petrol car, and like, so it kind of conked out. So my dad had to go and suck the petrol out, and he was sick.
I don't know who that was more dirty about. Okay, next up, Julie. This best friend Julie. Of the family of the week. Well, your best friend, remember?
Yes, well, Julie doesn't normally do stupid things, but this one, really, this is really stupid. She went, we're looking around a shore house, and Julie needed a break wind. So, like, she didn't want to do it in front of us because she would be embarrassed. So what she did, she went and opened this door and stuck her bum right through the door. And she let wind in, this other family was coming in behind, so she did it virtually in their faces. And she was then embarrassed.
She doesn't look like the sort of person that would ever break wind.
Well, it was dead loud as well. So
I think we get the idea. Thank you, Ricky. All right, now, Keith, your future brother-in-law, yep. Dish it.
Well, Keith, after a night out, he came in and he thought that his mum's jewellery box was the toilet, and it sprayed everywhere all around his mum's bedroom.
You didn't! Oh. Keith, you didn't! That is horrible! Thank you very much. I think Vicky did fantastically. Thank you for doing it. But Vicky, you know what?
I know I'm going to get it tomorrow, aren't I?
Thank you very much. You've said my line. 7:50. This is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast.
I'm Richard E. Grant. If you want to be a player, watch The Big Breakfast.
The Big Breakfast? Blooming marvellous!
Oh, it's 7:28. We're back now with this bit of the show. Gabby's making her way from the kitchen after dishing the dirt. It was good, lovely, lovely muck today. Lovely filth.
Okay.
It's Thursday, the 25th of August, 1994. That's the 25th of August, 1994. And today's a very special day because I want to talk about somebody's taken my Marmite, which I really need now.
Oh. Marmite!
This item is about Marmite, and they took it off my table, which is a bit mad, really, isn't it? Because, look, I couldn't help this noticing this when I went to shopping in Asda the other day. New jar of Marmite, new big serving jar, which is good, isn't it? Because we all love a bit of Marmite in the morning. You've got to dish it, dish the Marmite. And it says here, though, look, big value jar, 125 servings.
Are now, you sure?
Yeah, well, the thing is, you see, 125 servings, Who tests that? Which poor guy has to check out 125 servings? And look how long it must take, because look how long it takes for it to come off the knife. 125 times, that will take you 8 hours. That's an 8-hour day, 40-hour week. But also, what is a serving of Marmite? Because people like it, how can they say 125 servings? We all love Marmite here. It often keeps us going, especially in the winter, doesn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Peanut butter and Marmite, some people together. Jazz, though, for example, Jazz, who's very waif-like and very diminutive, just likes a little bit of Marmite. That's a serving to Jazz. Now, Jazz will get 600 servings out of this Marmite jar. Ronnie likes about the standard, a bit more. That's just over average, isn't it, for a Marmite spread? But you see, Rob, on the other hand... Rob! See, that is one serving to Rob, and the whole point is... And the whole point is about this claim here, 125 servings, but for Rob, there's about 4 servings in here. So, what is an official serving of Marmite? We need to know these kind of things. You see these kind of claims on all kinds of things. You see it on Smash, 8 servings. What is a serving? If you like a lot of mash, it's only one. Do you know what I'm saying? Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yes, Chris, we do.
So what I thought I'd do is I'd call up CPC UK Limited to make Marmite. They actually make Marmite. And I'd speak to somebody there, and this is what they said to us about the official serving of Marmite.
We have conducted hundreds of consumer tests that show the average serving is 4 grams. This is roughly a thumbnail-sized portion on the end of a knife.
There you are! And that's the official serving of Marmite. There you are! The claim is all right. They can claim that. It's fine by us. It's 7:53 now. If somebody in the gallery would like to tell us what's going on, just give us a clue. It'd just be nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it would be.
Absolute silence. Silence. Silence, which means we don't know what to do.
I think we'll just go to the ad break, shall we?
Well, no, we've got to keep them hooked, though. Got to keep the viewers hooked.
All right, OK.
And we've got to tell you that Ben the Boffin is going to bring on his celebrity goldfish later on.
Yes.
Forrest Gump. Right? Yes. And also, in 3 minutes from now, we're going to show you toilet paper that is only for men.
Oh!
It's true, it's from Germany, and it's in 3 minutes' time. Don't miss it.
For breakfast, I have a special bread that I make myself.
No way!
I toast it and butter it.
Wow!
And my cat, Percy, loves it. He thinks it's magic.
HMV presents the brand new Heavies. With the hits Dream On Dreamer, Back to Love, and their stunning new smash, Midnight at the Oasis. All featured on the brilliant new album, Brother Sister. The brand new Heavies at HMV. No HMV, no music.
Little guy, there's no need to fight over this. Let's talk it through over a can of iron brew.
Another bleeding heart liberal. Save it, Thunder Thighs.
But violence never solved anything.
Just my luck. An 8-foot Boy Scout. You heard the man. Let's go.
Who said the film has to be like the book?
It beats the living daylights out of other days out.
If you're a bit sick of the muggy weather, it's all cooled down today, hasn't it?
It's
got a lot fresher. Oh, so that's the weather then.
Just keep flicking away.
Yeah, 7:57, the big breakfast here. It's Thursday, the 25th of August, 1994. Coming up on the show between now and nine, Gaby talks to the teenage girl thrown off a night train
for not having a valid ticket. Gemma Graham, a mad from Byker Grove. I just thought I'd finish that sentence for you. Gemma Graham, a mad from Byker Grove, opens her GCSEs results live on the show. We are going to be speaking to her. She is going to be opening her results and finding out what she got. And we see if Danny makes the grade. We've set him the GCSE English exam and he's got the 2 hours to finish it in. 1 hour left.
One of our camera assistants, actually, he set it the first time 11 years ago. He's resetting the actual official exam from this year.
And he's sweating like
He's sweating. It's the one you all took, and we're going to mark his paper before the end of the show. Plus, Alec Baldwin reveals all in Snap, Cackle and Pop. And there's more famous footwear up for grabs in Whose Shoes. Also, you can meet Ben the Boffin's celebrity goldfish, because it's Celebrity Pet Day once again with Zig and Zag. It's 7:58 now, and now we have a very important thing, a solution to piddle puddles and dark patches on your trousers. It's true. Because, you know, sometimes us men, when we're having a wee, we're stood up. We all stood up. Some people sit down, you know, if you want to, but most people stand up. And we splash on the seat sometimes. Sometimes we forget to lift it up all the time. All right, we always do it. But more importantly than that, there's bits of water gets everywhere. It can be terribly embarrassing, especially when there's someone you're wearing quite a nice, snazzy safari suit. So we do have the solution to this. It's the first ever world's men's only toilet paper. And it's making quite a splash in Germany at the moment. And here it is. This is it here. It's where men are queuing. Yes, please. It's where men are queuing up in desperation to get a packet of 100 of these hygiene helpers, just for 3 Deutschmarks. Now that's just over a pound. Just 3 Deutschmarks. So that works about 3p each. But you can only use once you've used it. That's it. No good anymore. And what happens basically is you open it up at the end here. This is toilet paper for men. And I don't actually know how you do this, but maybe you blow.
It's very long.
It is very long. But Gaby, I think you underestimate me at times. Anyway, so what happens is, you look
at Angela's face. I don't know whether what Angela thinks of it.
Okay. Well, and you.
Hey.
You see? Now the thing is, this will start splashes on you and on your toilet seat. Very hygienic. Very hygienic indeed.
Yes.
Sounds a bit silly, but very hygienic.
Yes, good.
Because toilet paper, original toilet paper, must have sounded silly to the people who first saw it, because they said, "Well, we just do it on grass." They said, "Well, use paper from now on." So you might be using this. But the thing is about this. £80 this is worth, even though they're only 3p in Germany. £80 because it's the only one in Britain. It's a prototype and it's £80 worth, and this is the only one. So the lads here have been making their own.
Yes.
So Pete Leutner, what have you got from?
Well, Seth? This is only 25p, so this is much better value because there's not a lot to read in the Star.
Right.
And I have got a very large bladder, but very small. And,
yeah, okay.
I can fit this over quite nicely.
Don't have to go into graphic detail.
Oh, I beg
your
pardon.
You don't have to say fit this over, quote unquote.
And also, it's disposable, Chris. So.
And you can have a read of it beforehand if you like.
If you want to, I wouldn't bother.
Yeah, well, okay. Well, that's just Pete's opinion. That
it's
isn't
my opinion.
The opinion of Channel 4 or any of the people that work for him apart from Pete. Work for him, is Channel 4 a he? Okay. Andy, what have you got?
I got a sock, cut the end off it. Yeah, I have loads of them. Always have odd socks at home.
And reusable,
washable.
Of course.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Exactly. How many times would how many times would you use that before you washed it?
Once.
Just once?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And Dominic, this is quite ingenious. What is this?
Well, Chris, I never go anywhere without my convoluted pipe and guttering arrangements.
Right.
Perfect.
And you carry that unnoticed into discos and...
Just fits in your pocket snugly.
Really?
Yes, it does.
Like most things.
Indeed.
Okay, so there you are. Toilet paper exclusively for men. Pete.
Oh, no.
It doesn't work very well, does it? It sticks to the original. Here's the news now, isn't it?
Good morning, and these are the main stories on Thursday, August the 25th. Major rescue operation after Channel Ferry blaze. Two England team members leave Commonwealth Games following drug claims. And school children get record GCSE results. Over 100 passengers have this morning been rescued from a stricken Channel Ferry. Helicopters and lifeboats took part in the operation after an engine room fire left the Sally Star adrift near the treacherous Goodwin Sands. 6 years ago, the ship was hit by a similar blaze while on its regular route across the Channel. The English team in the Commonwealth Games has suffered a fresh setback with the sudden departure of runner Diane Modell. Officially, she's left Canada after a death in her family. It comes as shot putter Paul Edwards also returns home amid drug allegations. Athletics chiefs will make a statement about drug abuse later today. GCSE results out today show another record performance by the country's 16-year-olds. Numbers of entries for the exams are up, as are top grades for the seventh year running. Leader of the National Union of Teachers, Doug McAvoy, dismisses critics who say the exams are too easy.
I think really they are souring the success of the youngsters and get no credit for themselves. I think we should now be saying to those youngsters, well done.
Detectives investigating the discovery of human remains in the garden of a Leicestershire house have charged a man with murder. The grim discovery was made by police searching for 34-year-old Jean Crowe, who used to live at the house in Colville. She hasn't been seen for 16 years. EastEnders star Letitia Dean is quitting the soap after 10 years. The actress, who plays Queen Vic landlady Sharon, leaves next year, although the door is being left open for a possible return. Top reggae band Aswad has given Big Breakfast News an exclusive sneak preview of a new single to raise money for Rwanda. They've been recording Marvin Gaye's classic What's Going On. Later, they'll be joined in the studios by big names, including Gabrielle and Beverly Craven. And there'll be a Live Aid-style concert in October. Aswad say they had to do something for Rwanda.
Basically, we like to help whenever we can. And basically, we're making this record to save lives, to save the children.
Rangers manager Walter Smith has urged his players to maintain their domestic dominance following another early exit from the European Cup. The Scottish champions were beaten 1-0 by AEK Athens last night at Ibrox, going out of the Cup 3-0 on aggregate. Newcastle have swept to a 4-0 victory over Coventry despite the absence of injured skipper Peter Beardsley. Robert Lee scored the first and third goals within 15 minutes. Andy Cole added the fourth last night. Jürgen Klinsmann has celebrated his White Hart Lane debut in sensational style. The German international scored both goals in the first 36 minutes as Spurs defeated Everton 2-1 last night. Now let's look at the weather. Well, England and Wales will have sunny spells with a few showers. Scotland and Northern Ireland will have more frequent spells of rain. Temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. It's 4 minutes past eight. I'll be back at 20 past eight. Here's Chris and Gabby.
So we'll go to Leeds.
Yeah. Yes!
No, half of us are going to Leeds, half of us are going to Southampton.
OK.
Southampton, I support them.
Well, you go there then.
Yeah! Football! And all that!
He's completely barking.
Gone mad, hasn't he? He has actually gone mad. We love him, though. It's 4 minutes past eight, it's Thursday. Shall we look in the papers?
Go on.
OK, it's the silly season, of course, and lots of mad stories around today. A very nice story on the front page of The Sun. I don't know if this is on the front page of the later issues, because sometimes the issues change. This is the first issue, came out at 3 o'clock this morning. Ebony and Ivory. This is a couple here, a black and a white couple, and they've had a black and a white baby.
Oh, it's
unbelievable.
Such cute babies.
And the little boy is black, like his dad, and the little girl is white, like a mum.
That's incredible.
It's fantastic, isn't it? But shock, horror. Sharon's quitting his
No, sentence. She can't.
She's going.
She's
going. And you know why she's leaving?
Why?
Well, allegedly because she's having a baby too.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
The magic's in the milk. Anyway.
But you know what? We'd love you to come on. We'd love you to come on and tell us all about it, Letitia.
She never does interviews.
Yeah,
does she?
I know, but we adore her. We're
there was
her
that rumour about
fans.
Her. Do you remember there was everybody used to say she was going out with Bob Mortimer? Do you remember that rumour?
No.
Oh, maybe I dreamt it then. OK,
allegedly.
Silly season big time, and on page three of The Sun, this lady has won Spot the Ball, £250,000 on Spot the Ball. And they, you know how they say it's pure luck, Spot the Ball?
Yeah.
You don't know, no point in trying to guess.
Yeah.
Well, she's blind and she won.
Good for her.
Blind Lily Hyden has scooped £250,000 on Spot the Ball,
oh,
so good for her. It's literally that easy, there you are. What else is going on? Dottie Dot Griffiths. Wow, Dottie.Griffiths, a journalist's dream, wants to be buried with her gas cooker. Her New World 75, she bought it in 1954 for £18. She wants it buried with her because she loves it so much. It's in pristine condition. She services it every week. And she says about her cooker, she's my true friend, quote unquote.
Oh.
But she is married. And poor hubby Ted says, if it came to me or the cooker situation, I wouldn't fancy me chances. And there's a raider in Brazil went to hold up a cashier in a store to get £200, to rob her of £200. Didn't have a gun, took in instead a massive cockroach like that and threatened her with a cockroach. Take everything you want. Anyway. On the back page of all the papers today, Klinsmann scored two goals last night for Tottenham.
Yes!
And Tottenham beat Everton 2-1. It was his home debut. He scored two goals within the first 35 minutes. And people are now saying he's the best buy of the summer.
Is he the man that got hurt the other day as well?
Yes.
But he's all right now.
Oh, yes, he's very fine. He's also very funny. He's a nice bloke, actually. Yes. Seven minutes past eight.
Yes.
Today's question of the day. Because earlier on the show, we had a naked man. Now you believe us. Now you believe us. Just in case you don't. Now you believe us. We want to know, have you ever been caught with your kit off, or have you ever caught anybody else with their kit off?
Howard Linford from Lancashire. On holiday in Benidorm, I decided to surprise some girls in the next room by going balcony hopping with no clothes on. However, I picked the wrong room, which contained a family, and later was made to stand up an identity parade, and I got into trouble, so I'm asking everybody not to do that. Right, Tony Stevens from London. During our recent spell of good weather, I was working in the garden, and as our garden is well concealed, I stripped off. Unfortunately, when I climbed a ladder to hang some hanging baskets, I revealed myself to my neighbours who were all having a barbecue with their friends next door. I like that one. 0819851111 or factors 0119852222.
We want the naked truth, please, your naked stories. It's 8 minutes past eight now. I'm sorry about that.
I'm sorry
it was
where
terrible pun.
Where are you, Keith?
Good morning, welcome back to the Reading Festival. We've got a Down Your Doorstep special today because we're behind the scenes with a group of lads that, they have the dirty job of cleaning up after the rock stars. But we do have the rock stars with us. We have the Bang Chuck. Morning, folks.
Morning.
Look, we're going to clean up after the cleaning lads this morning, so let's go and wake them up. I'll tell you more en route because they have the demanding job of cleaning up after the rock stars. They travel to numerous festivals up and down the country. Janet Cole wrote to us about her husband, Brian Cole, who's in this porter cabin, I believe, with a host of other lads. Hello, good morning. This is your wake-up call. Keith Chegwin, you're on the Big Breakfast. Morning, which one's Brian Cole? You're Brian Cole.
Yes.
Good morning. Morning. How are you doing?
Oh, shattered.
Do you know why we're here?
I've got a clue.
You have the demanding job of cleaning up after all these rock stars, is that true?
That's correct.
Yeah. What are they like to look after? Are they dirty mob or what?
Very dirty.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. And well, we're going to change roles this morning because we have the rock stars with us. Come in, lads. Come in, lads. We're going to give you the day off, you see, because they're going to clean up after you.
Are they?
Yeah. Who are the rest of the team? Who are the other lads?
Dennis Towers.
Hiya, Dennis. Hello. You all right? Morning call for you?
Nigel's hiding in the corner over there.
Oh yeah. under the old duvet.
Yeah.
All right, we're at the Reading Festival. This is Brian Cole. It's your day off. We're going to clean up after you. I have to admit, the place is in a bit of a state.
I can imagine. I haven't seen it yet.
All right, you wake up. We'll sort you out.
Right,
back to the house.
Thank you very much, Keith, and we'll see you later. Schoolgirl Sally Hall has started a bitter feud between British Rail and her family. 15-year-old Sally claims she was thrown off a train for not having a valid ticket and ended up frightened and miles from her home. British Rail tell a different story, and Sally, her dad Brian, and BR's Colin Roby are here today. Welcome to all of you. Now, Sally, can you take me back? What happened? What time of day was this?
It was about 7:15 p.m.
Right, okay. Tell me what happened on the train.
Well, I was visiting friends in Malvern that I met in Greece. And I was travelling back and I got on the train and one ticket officer came over and he stamped my ticket and he said, that's okay.
Right.
And then another one came on at Worcester Foregate Street and he said, could I see your ticket? And I said, yes. And he said, it's invalid. And I tried to explain to him that I'd bought it and I didn't realise. But he didn't listen. He said, either you pay or you get off. And I only had 10p, so I didn't think that I could like pay it, so I had to get off.
Did he ask you to get off the train?
Yeah.
What did he say to you?
He just said, if you can't pay, you have to get off at the next station.
And you did that? How far from home was that?
It's about 10 miles.
10 miles from home. Okay. So what did you... 7 to 10 miles. What did you do when you were there, found yourself, 15-year-old, on the station, on your own at that time of night? What did you do?
I didn't know what to do and I was just like, really upset.
Did you not try and phone home?
I did, but then my money ran out because I only had 10p left.
And I mean, you probably were quite panic-stricken because you can reverse the charges, of course.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't think at the time.
You didn't think at the time. How did you eventually get through to your parents?
Well, this lady was using the phone before me and she let me use the phone. And because I like didn't arrange anything with my dad, I was really upset. And she said, well, if I give you some money, would you be able to get in contact with them? And I said yes, so she gave me some money to
phone
them.
Were you in tears at the time?
Yeah.
When you heard this phone call, when you got the phone call from your daughter, yeah. What did you do? I mean, obviously you rushed over to get her, but how did you feel about it?
Well, I was horrified to think that she was in the middle of nowhere, being put off a train, saying that the ticket was invalid. We wasn't aware at the time that the ticket was invalid. And I was horrified by it, you know. I just thought, this sort of thing doesn't happen.
So what did you do? Did you make some phone calls once she was back at home?
As soon as we came back, I rang British Rail at New Street, Birmingham. They told me there wasn't much they could do at that time of night. They would sort it out Saturday morning.
Did they sort it out?
And they would ring me Saturday morning. No, they were supposed to ring at 11 o'clock Saturday morning. Nobody rang. At 12 o'clock, I rang back. They said they were still looking into the... what had happened. We'll ring you again later on this afternoon.
What was the conclusion that they came to in the end, after all those phone calls? What did they say to you?
They told me that they'd had a word with the guard concerned, he'd been severely reprimanded, and if anything like this was to happen again, that he would be dismissed. Under no circumstances would he would just be dismissed.
All right, well, can I turn to you now, Colin Roby, from a production manager for BR. What have you heard about this story? What's your side of the story?
Well, the first we became aware of it within Regional Railways was when it actually appeared on Central News on Monday of this week. And
so you hadn't heard about this gentleman being reprimanded?
No, because my understanding is that when Mr. Hall rang, he spoke to a duty station manager at New Street, who I assume was not fully conversant with the facts anyway. But the situation, as far as we were concerned, was that the conductor on the train actually put in an incident report. His report actually stated that he'd approached Sally on the train and her ticket was actually out of date. It was a day return that was only valid for the day of issue. He'd then gone down the train to continue his ticket inspections between
Worcester and Droitwich, came back to take Sally's name and address, which is the normal procedure. The normal procedure in these situations is, I mean, we would not put people off trains.
Well, I was going to ask you, is it BR, put 50
the procedure,
miles off the train?
There is a laid down procedure. We take the name and address, and we then send a bill for the outstanding amount.
So you didn't finish that. He went back down the train and
he went back down the train and Sally had got off.
And Sally, you told me that he told you to actually get off the train.
Yeah, he did.
What's your reaction to this,
then? Why didn't the guard take Sally's name and address when he approached her about a ticket?
Because he has a commitment to collect revenue. He continued his trip to get tickets checked between Worcester and Droitwich. And the normal procedure, with Sally presenting a ticket to Kidderminster, I assume that his view was he'd go to get his tickets done between there and Droitwich.
Can I just say then, to this guard, the money was more important than Sally's safety?
No. Sally was on the train and was travelling to Kidderminster. The guard has a responsibility to check tickets between Worcester Foregate Street and Droitwich. Having seen Sally had got an out-of-date ticket, his report states that he told her that it was an invalid ticket, and he went down the train to carry on with his ticket collection, to then come back and see Sally, knowing she was going to Kidderminster. And we've in fact interviewed the guard since that, and the statement...
He's sticking to that story.
His statement is that he...
Can I ask when the report was put in?
The report would have been put in when the guard came off duty on Saturday.
That would be Friday night?
Friday night, yes.
Well, why wasn't I told this Saturday? Why was I told Saturday that he'd been spoken to, reprimanded?
I mean, you've both obviously been told two different stories. I think
this is from one of your managers.
No, this is not from one of my managers.
Well,
this
station
is,
manager.
This is
from New
this
Street.
Is from an intercity station manager at New Street who would not be aware of the facts, as it's not an intercity incident. Well, it's a regional railways incident.
Then why did he tell me that then?
I think you've obviously been told one thing from one station. You've heard another thing from the gentleman that was supposedly had put her off the train. This is what Sally said. I don't think it ends here. Obviously, it doesn't end here because you're both not in agreement. We've heard all sides of the story. I think we're going to be watching the news very carefully about this. And, Sally, I'm pleased that you're safe. You're all right now. That's good. It's 60 minutes past eight. The question about the clip is, who is Prince Ali? But remember, don't phone. It's just for fun.
Prince Ali, mad is he, Ali Ababa. Strong as 10 regular men, definitely.
He faced galloping hordes.
100 bad guys with swords.
Who sent those goons to their lords? Why, Prince Ali.
Wimbledon versus Bristol Wobble, and Bristol Wobble have a free kick. The manager's looking a bit wobbly. The wall has gone to jelly. Big Hart with his tasty left foot has really given it some jelly this time. Oh, my word, this boy's got bags of talent. It's a goal! Bassett's Jelly Babies, they're in a wibbly-wobbly league of their own.
Get on with it!
Weep for the crispy bits. These plucky innocents ask only to pursue their dream of maximum crispiness. And what do? We tie them down in toffee. We chain them in chocolate. There are literally hundreds of crispy bits bursting to get out of every single toffee crisp. And we, my friends, we can freedom!
That one's fine, Bill. One, two, one, two.
Dance to the Max 3. Masses of the best dance hits with the Prodigy, Max. Eternal and Capella. Massive hits from D-Ream, The Grid, Snap and Two Cowboys. The original smash from Dawn Penn.
No, no, no.
Unlimited, Culture Beat, Aswa, M People, Reel to Reel, and much more. 20 maximum dance hits. Dance to the Max 3.
How do you show just how refreshing Lipton Ice is? An azure sea, a cooling breeze, dazzling sun. No wonder he looks so happy.
Nice work, boys.
Do you think she meant it?
Sali, yes, it is he, but not as you know him. Read my lips and come to grips with reality. Yes, meet a blast from your past, whose lies were too good to last. Say hello to your precious Prince Ali.
Or should we say, Aladdin?
8:20. Aww, welcome back. Who was Prince Ali? Aladdin, of course! And that was from Walt Disney's Aladdin, the very first Disney movie to ever feature a belly button. It's out on video this week. Really? A belly button.
Is that true?
Yes.
What a great video that is.
Jolly good film.
I'm sure a lot of people would like that video.
I'm sure they would.
Yeah. It's 8:20. Amanda from Byker Grove is going to be on the phone later. She lives in Newcastle and she's going to phone us up as she opens her GCSE results and she's going to tell us what she needs and what she's received this morning. Also, we meet Ben the Boffin celebrity pet. It's a goldfish. Aww. Very exciting. And by the way, what are you doing this weekend?
I don't know yet.
Well, you know, I'm going to Edinburgh.
Oh, are you?
I went to the festival.
Oh, are you?
And I've been to Edinburgh before, one time before.
Yeah.
Well, I was in Edinburgh last time. When I went in my car. You know I went in my car, I told you about it. The car broke down. And I said to a lady, I said, excuse me, do you know a mechanic? She said, no, I know a Mackenzie in a Macintosh, but I don't know a
Mackenzie!
And also later on, in just a couple of minutes from now, we'll find out who owns this celebrity footwear in whose shoes.
Whose shoes? Whose shoes?
Josh, how'd you feel about that shot then?
I was quite embarrassed there.
Yeah, okay, good, all right. It's 8:21 now, and here's the news with Angela.
And the top stories this morning. Channel Ferry is adrift off the Kent coast after an engine room fire. No one's been hurt and the blaze is now under control. But helicopters and lifeboats have rescued all 104 passengers aboard the stricken Sally Star. Athletics officials will today make an announcement about drugs after two English competitors pulled out of the Commonwealth Games. Runner Diane Modal and shot putter Paul Edwards both flew out of Canada last night. Today's GCSE results show increased success for the seventh year running. The government has been joined by Labour and the Liberal Democrats in congratulating both teachers and pupils. Hollywood's famous giant sign has been given its own high-tech security system. Now cameras and radar track would-be vandals, while a loud hailer warns them that police are on their way. Now the weather, sunny spells and showers across the country, temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. I'll be back at 20 to 9. It's just 22 minutes past 8 now. Here's Chris and Gabby.
Thank you very much,
I know
Angela.
A Mackenzie and a Macintosh, but I don't know a mechanic. Scotland.
Terrible, Chris.
Angela like that one.
You like that, didn't you, Angela?
Yeah, funny,
boy. What's your favourite joke, Ange?
There's a good one going around at the moment, a good knock-knock joke.
Knock-knock?
Who's there?
OJ.
No, you're supposed to say it yourself. <other day.
laughs> OK, you do it on me.
It's OJ who?
OJ who?
You're on the jury.
You see? It's 8:22. That was my second joke today. That was going to do later on, and she did it.
And Angela pipped you.
Anyway, now it's time to find out who owns the celebrity footwear in whose shoes.
Whose shoes? Whose shoes?
Where are the clues? Oh, John, how do you feel about this item? Yeah? Okay. Right, the clues to last week's shoes, which are in fact these shoes here. Oh, sorry. A sign of things to come, I think. They are size 9, and they smell like a man. Clue number 2 was this man is always seen out with a bird on his arm. And clue number 3 was he sent feathers flying. What are you doing?
I'm scared.
Oh, that's not all. When he appeared on the Michael Parkinson show. And the answer is, who is it? It's...
No!
It's... Roger!
Sitting here.
Hello, Rod.
Hello, Mike.
How are you?
Oh, it's lovely here.
Hello, Emu.
It's just like the pink windmill, isn't it, Emu?
He's calmed down a lot, Emu, you said, didn't you?
Yes, he's very
he's
nice.
He's all right now,
yeah.
Isn't he?
Yeah.
You can stroke him now, Gabby.
Yeah, you can stroke him.
He's fine now. He's lovely. He's always been lovely, really. He's just misunderstood.
Absolutely.
Quite
all
right, yes.
Pick a winner. Okay. Pick a winner. It's all these people.
Okay. All these people.
Gently does it, Emu. Gently does it.
Emu, have a go.
Okay, just gently. That's it. Just
gently. Stop it.
No!
Wait a minute, I'm trying to find one.
Oh, you've got a winner.
Right.
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, it's me.
Let's have a look. Let's see who it is. Rose Elliot from
he's
Worthing.
Lovely,
I'm so scared.
He from likes you.
Rose Elliot from Worthing in Sussex is the winner.
Oh, okay.
And now.
Oh,
well done, anyway. Well done to the winner. Okay. Right, now, that was last week. Rod, you've got to give those shoes to the winner.
Those shoes to the winner.
And
Rose
now, here's the shoekeeper, Toby Tumpkin Love Bucket, with this week's shoes and the clues.
Shoe clue number one.
They're size 2. They smell like a woman.
Shoe clue number 2.
She loves a right carry-on.
Shoe clue number 3.
This fine-footed female shares her surname with the Queen.
There you are! Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, shoekeeper. I'm shaking, right? And if you know the answer to that, send it to Who Shoes the Big Breakfast, 2 Lock Keepers Cottages, on board Lock London E32NH.
Okay, you take 25. What
you
are
can have
next?
It. Oh, you can have it.
We're going to ask Keith, where is he? Where are you, Keith?
Where are you?
Hey, thanks very much, Chris. There's like chaos going in there, but it's tranquility here at the Reading Festival behind the scenes, because we got a letter from a lady called Janet Cole in Newcastle, who tells about her husband, Brian Cole, who's one of the cleaners here. He has to clean up after the rock stars. Reverse of roles this morning, because we've got rock stars Chuck.
Sorry, Keith, you can't come in here with those muddy boots.
I'm a megastar. top man, Chuck, cleaning up after our cleaners. Look, he's doing a bit of ironing here, Mark, Paul. And we've got Gray in there doing a bit of dusting and more. I think it might work easier if the old Hoover's on. And I tell you what, it might work better, look, if the iron's plugged in. But look, we have our cleaners here. Look, sitting down, relaxing. What a change. Is it usually quite hectic round here?
It is, yes.
Yeah. So it's what sort hectic. Of people, who do you clean up after?
Brian Adams, Dire Straits. Guns N' Roses.
So you've had them all, really?
Oh,
yeah, who are your teammates here?
This is Nigel Burns.
Hi, Nigel.
And on my left is Dennis Towers.
Right, so who's been the best to clean up? Who's the cleanest person?
Well, I would say Brian Adams, most of all.
Immaculate, is he?
Immaculate.
Yeah, and who's the dirtiest?
It has to be Guns N' Roses.
Oh, no! Tell me why.
Just a bunch of animals.
Oh, no! Allegedly.
Yes, or bottles thrown and everything.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But you've met some nice people, sort of like, while you've been on the road, haven't you? Tell me who.
Yes, where we've seen Brian Adams and a couple of the lads have seen Madness and all them.
Oh, what were Madness like?
I wasn't there.
You weren't there, but you were?
I was there. Very nice lads. Got a drink off them.
Oh, good stuff. Very good. Hey, who's this posh caravan next door?
Oh, that's the bosses.
Look at this, Sean, look. Hey, how come he's got the... Come here, lads. How come he's got the best caravan going and you're in the porter cabin over the way? Hello, Brian, are you
all
in?
Right.
Thank you. How are you doing? You're
fine,
right.
Thank
this
you.
Is
yes.
Hey, look, we want to know on the Big Breakfast. Come and sit over here because we can't see you.
Yeah, sure.
We want to know how come you got this real sort of like posh environment. What are the lads doing over there?
Well, that's their base cabin. Yeah. You know?
Well, look,
we use that every show.
We've decided on the Big Breakfast that this is going to be their base cabin. Lads, come on in. Make yourself at home.
Boys.
Put your feet up. Is the shower on? Is it working?
Yeah, oh yes, the child's working, yeah.
He's got a port-a-loo in here and more so he can relax. Good news is, we said with the reversing roles this morning, the cleaners aren't cleaning, but they are going to be a rock band because you're going to be singing Wild Thing live at the Reading Festival very shortly. Back to the house. See you later.
Thank you, Keith. It's 8:28, Reading Festival fever sweeping the country.
Yes!
Edinburgh Festival fever sweeping the country, and Gabby's having a tea party on Saturday afternoon, and tea party fever is also sweeping the country.
Excellent.
What? I know. I'm not going to look.
Do you know, I was really scared.
I know, I'm really scared right now.
I was terrified.
There's an emu outside.
If you'd like some fun in the sun, we'll get your knobbly nuts out.
Get your knobbly nuts out. Get your
knobbly.
Get your knobbly nuts out.
Get your nobbly nuts out. Fantastic.
Look, I'll keep watch. You do the number.
Okay. The number for you to call is 0891 333 311. Call should cost no more than 25 pence, and you could win the bodyboards and the girl wetsuits, or you could win that fantastic holiday to the Mediterranean. I'm
that
scared.
Way, that way.
Right. Okay. Now the question. The question about the clip is, how is this man making his money? Remember, don't phone. Oh, he's gone. It's just for fun.
There's so many people interested and so many people excited about it. And it's going from a little acorn to a big oak tree. I'm very excited about it.
What are you most excited about?
The money.
Groovin', 20 soulful summer grooves, chill to Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince, PM Dawn, groove to Warren G, De La Soul, Arrested Development, and Alaya. Cruise through summer with Groovin'.
Mr. Soft, won't you tell me why the world in which you're living is so strange? Oh, Mr. Soft, how come everything around you is so soft and rearranged?
Bite through the shell of a Tribor soft mint and everything turns chewy and soft. They're crispy on the outside, chewy on the inside.
Now for fantastic looking hair, a breakthrough by L'Oreal. L-Serve Care Mousse Non-Rinse Conditioner. After every shampoo, discover the first care conditioner in a mousse, and you don't have to rinse out. So you can detangle and perfectly condition in an instant. Now my hair is softer, shinier. L-Serve Care Mousse Conditioner makes my hair light and bouncy.
L-Serve Care Mousse Conditioner by L'Oreal. Instantly beautiful hair without the rinse.
Like any product, the maggot has to be made attractive to potential customers. A little bit of artificial colouring makes all the difference. The end results look clean, colourful and tempting. Almost good enough to eat. For a fish, at any rate.
Welcome back to the Wriggly Big Breakfast. The question was, how did that man make it? The answer, maggots. And that was from QED, which tells the story of Bruce Silcock, a maggot mogul who plays millions of out of his maggots. And QED's BBC One tonight at 8:20 p.m. Good show.
Very good show. And maggots, cleanest organism in the world, because they actually produce ammonia.
Really?
They actually produce ammonia themselves. That's how clean they are. Yeah. It's a big myth that they're
I touched the maggots.
Now, when you say eat them, you know, don't eat them. You do put them in your mouth to warm them up and they wriggle more when you're fishing, but you don't actually eat them, because that'd be a bit stupid, wouldn't it? Still to come, we're going to find out how Danny Stegall, our little camera assistant, has done, because Danny is resitting his English language GCSE exam now. Not because he has to, just because we thought it'd be a bit of fun. For about 2 hours, he's going to do it. Then we're going to give out the results. We're going to mark his paper before the end of the show, because today is, of course, the day that 600,000 people get their GCSE results.
And also Gemma, who plays Amanda in Byker Grove.
Byker Grove.
She's going to be opening her results live on the show, so we'll find out about her results. She'll be on the telephone very shortly, find out what results she got in her GCSE.
What she needs and what she's got. It's 8:33. Here's some autumn movie news now.
Snap, Cackle, Pop.
Today on Snap, we look forward to the big movie releases this autumn. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is what's coming soon on
Movie News on Snap, Cackle and Pop.
Movie News.
Howdy doody, in just a couple of weeks' time, we'll be hoeing down exclusively with Kevin Costner and Dennis Quaid, the stars of September's big western, Wyatt Earp.
You want to go out in a blaze of glory? I'm with you.
I think people want to see a movie and not necessarily me.
Kevin is Wyatt Earp, the legendary lawman who cleaned up the Wild West along with his best buddy, Doc Holliday, a role Dennis Quaid had to slim down for.
Doc Holliday had tuberculosis. He weighed about 135 pounds. And
self-control got the better of me.
I lost 43 pounds. It took about 3 months to lose it, and then I had to keep it off, which was the difficult part, for another 3 months.
Snap.
Speed promises to be the most exciting thriller to come your way in eons. Keanu Reeves battles to save a busload of innocent passengers from a mad loony psycho, Dennis Hopper, who's planted a bomb primed to go off if the bus goes slower than 50 miles an hour.
I haven't played any regular guys in so long, I wouldn't know what that was like.
What do you think, Jack? You think if you pick up all the bus driver's teeth, they'll give you another medal?
It's been nicknamed Die Hard on a Bus, and it's already caused a sensation in America, earning over $108 million. It's released here at the end of September, and we'll be finding out all about how babe magnate Keanu prepared for life as an action star.
I ate 3 square meals a day and lifted weight and did some running.
Big breakfast viewers will be given the chance to see sexy Keanu first. Just watch this space.
Careful.
The Client is the third John Grisham movie to come out in less than a year, hot on the heels of The Firm and The Pelican Brief. This time, the lawyer under pressure is played by Susan Sarandon. Or is it Sarandon?
My name is like abandon, Sarandon. It only got more complicated as I became more famous, but you just say simply Sarandon.
Sarandon plays a dime store lawyer who defends a kid who's witnessed a mob crime. Don't you just hate when that happens?
You know, I have to say, I've had more problem with grown-up co-stars.
Bob. And Nicolas Cage finally says ciao to his bad boy days, Bridget starring Fonda. Alongside the babe-alicious Bridget Fonda and the racy Rosie Perez in It Could Happen to You.
We won something, what did we win?
$4 million.
It's the touching tale of a cop who wins the lottery and gives half of his fortune to a down-at-heel waitress.
I gave a $100 bill once as a tip for a $6 meal because the waiter was really rude to my mother and I didn't want him to forget.
Will they fall in love? Snap wouldn't be at all surprised.
It's like a fairy tale.
Snap.
How did you know who I am? The shadow knows.
Snap just loves a good superhero, so we're thrilled to bits about The Shadow. The tale of an elusive crime buster was a top-rated radio favorite in the 50s, and now it's a stylish screen sensation starring Alec Baldwin.
I dreamed I tore all the skin off my face and was somebody else underneath.
You have problems.
We'll be trying to talk to Alec in October.
When things don't go my way in dealing with the media, then I transform into a hideous monster. Truly, literally. Furniture smashing, fist through the wall, psychopath.
If you think you can handle Alec's mood swings, then make sure you tune in to Movie News, coming soon on Snap, Cackle and Pop.
Cackle.
On today's chart, we look at 3 snogs that almost happen, but not quite, in movies out now.
Number 3.
Jamie Lee Curtis air kisses Arnie in True Lies. He's over there, Jamie. Jamie! Oh, never mind.
Number 2.
The long-awaited Jack Nicholson movie Wolf is released tomorrow. And can this be true? Does Michelle Pfeiffer have to handcuff him to get a snog? Get away.
And at number 1.
It's official. The best nearly snog of the week is between supermodel Cameron Diaz and cartoon comic Jim Carrey in The Mask. Don't phone. Snap doesn't have her number.
Tomorrow.
Yo, Hulkamaniacs! I'm Hulk Hogan, the WCW Heavyweight Champion, and don't miss me on tomorrow's Snap. What you gonna do?
Now, who will watch Snap, Cackle and Pop tomorrow after that? It's not exactly enticing, is it? A man who's far too old to be dressed like that. Dressed like that, saying, watch me.
Next week... Do that again. Next week on Snap, exclusively, we're very, very excited, and the ladies are extremely excited because we have got Paul Newman. We've also got Tim Robbins. And we've also got Andy Garcia.
Don't like him.
You want to faint like everybody else, don't you? Okay, I got your faint. I got a faint for you. I know you like Robbie Coltrane. See? She does. She genuinely does. Don't you? You do like Robbie Coltrane, don't you?
You know how to get to the girls.
Hang on a minute. Hang on a minute. Is it? You're leaving, aren't you?
Yeah.
She's leaving in 3 weeks' time.
No! Keep her!
And you're leaving, aren't you?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
No! Keep her!
But the worst news of all is you're not leaving, are you? She's not leaving.
No,
we'll all have to leave instead.
Yeah. Gemma, who plays Amanda in Byker Grove. We're going to be finding out about her GCSE results live on the show. She's going to make a phone call and she's going to open up that envelope.
I thought about doing that last night in the bath and I couldn't wait. I've been waiting all show to do that.
But the quest for the clip is, who's the baby in the furry bikini? Remember, don't phone. It's just for fun.
A very special double album.
This is a man's
world. At a very special price.
The tears of a clown.
40 tracks. Bringing together the finest voices spanning four decades with one thing in common.
Get here.
They're all committed to soul on Arcade.
Turkish delight, full of Eastern promise.
Wherever there is danger, there is
Mighty Max. We could be in trouble.
Mighty Max and the Doom of Dragon Island.
Hey, Scully, how you doing?
Better than you, puny one.
Normie, the dragon?
It'll be a pleasure.
Eliminate them, my trusty Terminators. You can't escape, Skullmaster! Mighty Max and the Doom of Dragon Island. Will he escape? He's facing your... my hands!
Ooh, don't you treat this house like a hotel! Don't you treat this house like a hotel! Don't you treat this house like a hotel! Don't you treat this house like a... Hang your coat up properly!
Just!
Let's see that tasty winning goal again. Hang on, he saved it! Bassett's Jelly Babies, they're in a wibbly wobbly league of their own!
Best rock album in the world, ever. Hit after explosive hit. One classic track after another. 38 of the greatest rock anthems the world has ever known. It can only be the best rock album in the world, ever.
One million years BC was proudly touted as Hammer's 100th production. It was also the first of their prehistoric epics. John Richardson and Raquel Welch are the cave people.
Well, there you are. There's our special effects. 15p from Argos, each one of them.
The question about the clip was, who was the babe in the furry bikini? Raquel Welch, and that was from The World of Hammer, narrated by the original Hellraiser, Oliver Reed. Tonight, Ollie's talking about the incredible visions of other worlds created by filmmakers. It's on Channel 4 at 5 past midnight tonight.
Thanks, Ross. Now, of course, we're just talking about Hulk Hogan, and John just told us a story here that when he came to the house one day, he came to do some trails after some jiggles, saying, hi, Hulk Hogan, you're watching The Big Breakfast and all this stuff, in his silly pink outfit. And we said, can you do the trails outside? He said, it's too cold. And he wouldn't go, would he, John? He wouldn't go outside because he was too cold. It's 8:43 on this morning, a very special morning. 600,000 people are waiting for their GCSE results. And we've set Danny here, our camera assistant, the official English language GCSE paper from this year. He's been doing it since 7 o'clock. He didn't know he was going to do it. It's years ago since he did his original paper. And we're going to tell you how he's done before the end of the show.
I'm going to let you into secret as well. He's got earplugs in so nobody puts him off.
Really?
Yeah, he's sitting there with earplugs in. It's now 8:43. Yes. Here's Angela with the news.
And the top stories this morning, 104 passengers have been rescued from a Channel ferry after a fire knocked out its engines off the Kent coast. A skeleton crew is remaining aboard the Sally Star, which was hit by a similar blaze in 1988. Runner Diane Modell and shot putter Paul Edwards have both pulled out of the England team in the Commonwealth Games in Canada. Later this morning, athletics officials will make a statement about alleged drug taking. An American peace mission, which is pressing for an indefinite IRA truce, has arrived in Ireland. They'll meet the Irish Prime Minister, Albert Reynolds, and Sinn Féin in their quest for a truce. A new survey says traffic jams bring out the worst in men, but the best in women. While male drivers are likely to swear, women will relieve the strain by singing, according to a Cellnet poll. Now the weather, sunny spells and showers across the country, temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. It's coming up to a quarter to nine. We'll be back just before nine with the closing headlines. Here's Chris and Gabby.
Thank you very much, Angela. Earlier on the show today, we had a nude man. We had a nude man. There you go. And they were looking at it so intensely in VT that they forgot to play it in because they were studying it themselves. Just one more time. That was earlier on the show, and look at the delight on our faces, and his cheeks were smiling as well. So we're asking you, what about your nude stories? Got any nude stories? Kylie Anderson from Worthing. When I was on holiday, our friends told us to get up early in the morning as the nudist beach got really full and to mark our spot. So we were there with all our clothes off, and it wasn't a nudist beach.
Oh, no, that's so cruel. Julie Danaher from Sidcup. My friend got out of the bath and went to her room to get dressed. As she walked in, she took her towel off and looked to see the window cleaner at her window. She was so embarrassed that she couldn't bring herself to pay him and has never spoken to him since.
Oh. It's quarter to nine. This is the big breakfast. You can have fun in the sun by getting your knobbly nuts out. And that's what we shout from time to time.
Get your knobbly nuts out. Get your knobbly. Get your knobbly nuts out. Get your
knobbly
nuts out.
Toby Tompkins and the nuns.
I don't know what's more shocking, the naked man or the nuns getting the get your knobbly nuts out.
Of course, she costs no more than 25 cents. You can win the two bodyboards, the two wetsuits, or a holiday in the Mediterranean.
It's 8:46. That's the time.
It is.
Where are you, Keith?
Thanks very much. You won't believe this. My heart's a pounding. Even Sean's nervous here this morning because we've got backstage at the Reading Festival. And you're not going to believe this. A real first in television history. We've managed to grab a quick interview with Brian Cole and the Cleaners. They're here at the moment backstage, about to perform live on stage. Nigel, you've got time
Sorry, I don't give interviews, Keith.
I'm sorry about that. Brian, we wouldn't upset you if we had a quick chat.
No, I wouldn't, mate.
Yeah, what's it like here at Reading? Nervous?
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Being the opening band bit. Here?
Yeah, not too bad. A few butterflies here and there.
Have you been played by autograph hunters?
Yeah, we have done, yes.
All right. Well, you've got to get ready for your set, so have a nice one, folks. Let's go out on stage here at Reading Festival. We've got top rock band Chuck with us. Hi, Chuck, how you doing? All right, they're going to back our brand. So, ladies and gentlemen, can I just say to everybody here at Reading, you've got Primal Scream tonight. You've got Red Hot Chili Peppers. You've got the Lemonheads. But right now, it's time to welcome the biggest band here at the Reading Festival. Opening, please welcome Brian Cole and the Cleaners. Here they go! And it's their new single, bound to be a chart winner. They performed it on Radio 1. It's Brian Cole and the Cleaners with Wild Thing. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
Wild Thing. You make my heart sing. You make everything groovy. Wild Thing, I think I love you. But I wanna know for sure. Come on and hold me tight. I think I love you.
Cleaners. Ryan, it was your wife Janet who wrote to us. Have you got anything to say to her there?
Yes, I'm going to see you when I get to home.
Thanks very much. To Brian Carl, thanks very much to Chuck. Good luck with the record in the charts. And everyone here at Reading Festival, sound, lighting and more. And a big thank you, look, to our crowd. Well done, folks. That's all from us. Back to the house. He's Chris and Gabby.
And if you are going to the Reading Festival, then be safe, be sensible, but have a great time.
Absolutely.
And plenty of crowd surfing. That's what you want. All right, that's quite genuine, isn't it?
Yeah.
Respect is due to me, thank you. Now, what's going on? Oh, we got Gemma Graham on the phone now. Gemma Graham plays Amanda in Byker Grove. And this is Gemma here. And Gemma's on the phone. Hello, Gemma.
Hello.
How the devil are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Now, you're waiting for your GCSE results today like everybody else, aren't
yes.
you?
Yes.
And yours have arrived at your house.
Yes.
Now, apparently, you want to carry on with your drama, of course. You want to go to sixth form college. You want to be take drama. And what else do you want to take?
I'm going to take a GCSE in photography
okay.
in 3 year levels.
Right. And for that, you need 4 C's from your GCSEs, don't you?
Yes.
To get to your sixth form college.
Yes.
Okay. This is Emma, and she's Gemma, rather, and she's speaking live from Newcastle with her envelope in her hand. Now, have you looked at your envelope?
No, not yet.
How many GCSEs have you taken?
9.
Open that envelope and tell us what you've got.
Okay.
Amanda from Byker Grove revealing her GCSE results live on the telly.
Oh, oh my God. Okay, well.
Okay.
I got 4 C's.
4 C's! Yay! Now, where was the Hitchcock-esque suspense in that reveal? Well, tell us exactly what you got. Go down the list.
Oh, do I have to?
Yeah, quickly.
Oh, no, right. I got C for history.
Yes.
E for French. E for PE. 2 E's for science. And E. No, C for English. C for English Lit. E for maths. And a C for information technology.
You only got 4 C's, didn't you?
Yes.
It was the skin of your teeth, but you did it by an inch or a mile. Well done.
Thank you.
Okay, well done. Thank you. Thank you for coming on as well. Bye. Bye, Byker Grove, Byker Grove. It's 9 minutes to 8, and of course our own Danny Steggall is taking his English language exam as we speak, and Danny is busy almost finishing his paper. This is the actual English language exam that people sat this summer, and we're going to let you know how he did just before the end of the show.
Oh, he's sweating a little bit, but it's not 8:51. Yeah, but it's a lot of a little bit.
Okay, right.
A lot of a little bit. 8:51 after the break. Time to get your knobbly nuts out.
Bye. Bye.
After eating most meals and snacks, plaque pH can fall. Acid can then attack teeth for up to 2 hours, which, as your dentist will tell you, increases the risk of tooth decay. But when you chew for 20 minutes after eating, you produce more of your mouth's natural defense, saliva, which helps neutralize acid within minutes. So chew Orbit or Wrigley's Extra as part of your dental care routine, because chewing is scientifically proven to fight the plaque acid that causes cavities.
Is the sound man on the bus yet? Oh! Did everyone get their complimentary Imperial Leather antiperspirant last night?
Long-lasting protection for you and everyone close to you from Imperial Leather.
No chance of getting the roof off, I suppose.
Oh, no. We've gone too far this time.
One too many and you might turn Bertie.
What's going on in Polly Pocket? There's a tiny world where we can go, with special places that are all aglow. New Polly Pockets light up tiny world. There's a pizza parlor with lots to eat, a school and a church where everyone meets. What's going on? What's going on?
New Polly Pockets light up tiny world. That's what's going on.
This story, Justin. Whilst shreddies have been busy with their layer upon layer of whole wheat, keeping hunger locked up till lunch, the alien flingons have escaped. There's 4 to catch. Fling them through the air and watch the alien suckers stick to any shiny surface. Alien flingons, free inside shreddies.
If it's got to be white, it's got to be Hovis.
Did you know that some cats have never even tasted kitty cat?
That's right, yeah.
haven't they?
Not so much as a nibble, mate.
What, not even the new tuna and the salmon?
Not a lick.
All them lovely tender chunks and everything?
Yep. Not so much as a sniff of the tin,
mate. Oh, dear. And why is that, then?
Well, their owners forget to buy it for them, don't they? They treat them like dogs, some of them.
That is iniquitous, that
is. Yes. Well, no, it's in jelly.
That's right. Yeah. That's in jelly, that is. Kitty cat. Us cats thrive on it.
Get your knobbly nuts out. There you are, the knobbly nutty nuns. It's time to get your knobbly nuts out. We need a caller. Hello, who's on line, which line? Line two. Who's on line?
Hello,
who are you?
Claire from Plymouth.
How are you, Claire from Plymouth?
Fine, thanks.
What's the weather like?
It's all right, it's getting nice.
Is it getting nice? Yeah. Oh, maybe it'll come out. It's very cloudy here, but very fresh today. Lots of nice negative ions in the air. We've got our nutter, of course, here on our Rusco, and we've got Marion, our lifeguard. Hello, Marion, how are you? And we've got Steve, our nutter, once again. Steve, a dancer on the word, and came third in the final of Mastermind. Can you believe it? He's a top man, Steve. Very quiet, though, quite reserved. Bit of a recluse, really. He looks quite outgoing, but quite quiet. Unbelievable. Anyway, you're playing for a holiday to the Mediterranean, or if you get two nuts out of our pun instead of three, you'll get these body boards, and you'll get these wetsuits. All right? You know how to play the game, don't you?
Yeah.
It's very simple. He's going to be blindfolded. You've got to shout him left, right, and guide him to the nuts and get him out of the pool. You've got to get three out within 30 seconds. But here come your questions now to determine how many nuts we put in the first place. And they're all kind of breakfasty, cutlery, foodie kind of things. And question number one goes like this. Sometimes the atmosphere is so thick you can cut it with a what?
Knife.
Is the right answer. That's for three nuts. For four nuts, we're going to ask you this question now. Which of these is smaller, a coffee or a teaspoon?
Coffee spoon.
Smaller, yes?
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. That's fine. Four nuts in the pool. And finally, for five nuts now in the pool, answer this question right. If you were to look at yourself in the back of a dessert spoon, would you look like A, Pete Townsend, B, Zig, or C, Angela Rippon? No, it's actually Pete Townsend, unmistakably, and everybody knows that. Try it yourself. Kids try it at home just after the show's over, but not yet. So you get four nuts in the pool. Here we go. You ready with the nuts? We put one in. Put your blindfold on, Steve. Two, three, and four. Okay, let's go. Let's get your doubly nuts out.
Left. Get your nuts out. left, get your nuts out.
Well, that was actually your fault there, wasn't it? Because you went the wrong way once or twice.
Yeah.
Never mind, but you got two, so you get the body boards and the wetsuits. And, of course, living in Plymouth, you can make use of those.
Yep.
It's nice and warm at this time of the year in Plymouth, isn't it? It's warm all year round, in fact. So congratulations. Well done. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you to Steve. Thank you to Marion. Thank you to everybody involved in that last item. And now here's the news.
And the closing headlines. More than 100 passengers are safe after being rescued from a blazing Channel ferry this morning. Helicopters raced to the Sally Star after a fire knocked out its engines, but no one was hurt. And a Lithuanian ship off Shetland has sent out a Mayday call reporting a fire on board. 72 men are aboard the fish factory ship. Lifeboats are on the way. The Manchester-based electricity company Norweb has announced this morning that it's cutting 1,200 staff. The jobs are going in response to price cuts recently ordered by the electricity watchdog. Now the weather, sunny spells and showers across the country. Temperatures around 18 centigrade, 64 Fahrenheit. Leeds and Southampton have the lowest chance of rain. News happening later today, nurses will call for tougher checks on private old people's homes, and Chris Eubank gives details of his next title defence. That's it from the newsroom. Back to the house.
Thank you very much, Angela. The Big Breakfast, 8:58.
And now it's time for another fantastically good-looking man.
And today's guy is John Slate, 23, from Walthamstow. John used to be a fruit and veg man, his girlfriend works in a bank, and we know he's going to be a big hit with the girls who know their onions. Thank you, John. Now, if you could turn the sign around for me, please, John, thank you very much. We are looking for fantastically good-looking bridegrooms. The Big Breakfast, Two Lot, Keep Scotch's Old Ford, Lock, London, for the week after next.
Now, there's a bit of an anticlimax then, because we didn't really give you the cheer you deserve, fantastically good-looking man, because we're all concentrating on Danny's results. We set Danny Steggle here, our camera assistant, without him knowing this morning, this year's English language paper. And how many years ago is it since you took your last GCSE, Danny?
15 years.
15 years ago. So let's see how he did, because we have our chief examiner here. What's he done? How's he done?
Read that out before you announce that.
He showed a good understanding of the text and the questions. He had a couple of spelling errors to begin with. Then he became a fluent writer who understands and comprehends complex issues.
You've got 10 seconds to tell us how he did.
He should read more widely, though.
Read, give that.
And he got a solid C.
A solid C! Back on the air again tomorrow to start your weekend with a bang. Bye-bye. Have a great Thursday.